There's no coffee maker and there's no coffee in this place.
Does this have no caffeine? So I'm subletting this place from a good friend of mine who I used to work with, and I had no idea she doesn't drink coffee or any caffeine. Good thing I got this roasted green tea from Japantown because I'm gonna need this today. We, meaning you and me, we've got a lot to cover today. So today I thought I'd make a video about a day in the life of a YouTuber slash creator based out of San Francisco. I've been home for the last few weeks, kind of just been holed up editing videos and hanging out with my family, and I'm going to be leaving again pretty soon here, so this would be a good time to show you what my daily routine looks like behind the scenes. But first, coffee. I've never made it a habit to go out and get coffee in the morning, but for this special circumstance, I want to take you guys to a really cool coffee shop here in the neighborhood. Trieste is an icon here in North Beach. It's been here since the 1950s during the Beat Movement, so this place was a hangout for Jack Kerouac and other Beat poets and writers. And this is also the spot where Francis Ford Coppola wrote parts of the screenplay for The Godfather. If you guys have been following my channel for the last few months, you've probably noticed that I've been moving from place to place. Also, welcome to all you new subscribers. I've been getting a lot of comments lately that YouTube hasn't been notifying subscribed accounts, so in that case, just make sure that you hit that notification bell. Typically, when I'm looking for a new spot to live and work, I need three things: a sitting workspace, a standing workspace, and a whole lot of natural light. And before I even open my computer, I need my blue light filter glasses, which I'm going to try on right now with Warby Parker's home try-on kit. I'm really excited to be partnering with Warby Parker today. Warby Parker is committed to providing exceptional vision care online and in stores, offering eyeglasses, sunglasses, eye exams, and contact lenses. They have a really cool and unique way to try on glasses. Just go online and take a short quiz about the kind of glasses you're looking for. Warby Parker will suggest some glasses to fit your face and your style, so you can take the quiz to find a pair that is perfect for your face. Glasses start at $95. You can order 5 pairs of glasses right here to try on for 5 days. Which ones do you think look best? Do I look like a teacher or a librarian? Warby Parker, you're killing it. 2 out of 2. These remind me of my grandpa. These are the classic crowd-pleasing Harry Potter glasses. Once you decide which one you want to keep, you ship the entire package back and let them know which one you liked the most. Then, depending on if you have a prescription or if you wanted blue light filter lenses, they will ship you back your personal pair that you chose. Try the Warby Parker free home try-on program. Order 5 pairs of glasses to try at home for free for 5 days. There is no obligation to buy it. Shipping is free and it includes a prepaid return label. Thank you, Warby Parker. Try 5 pairs of glasses at home for free at warbyparker.com/HaleyWorld. I think I'll give these ones a try today. All right, now let's get the day started. So I have a pretty tight schedule every day, but no day is ever the same. As a content creator, my primary focus is my YouTube channel, which takes up most of my time. I have set days of the week where I'm either writing video ideas, then writing outlines, then scripting the video, and then going into production mode, which is the filming, the shooting, the editing, and the uploading. What follows my YouTube content is my Instagram content. So I have a strategy that works in sync across all of my social media platforms. And so goes the same with Facebook and Twitter. TikTok is kind of a different, more fun and playful one that I haven't spent enough time on, but I'm getting there. Since my YouTube channel is my main focus and takes the most amount of time and work, everything I do is kind of dialed around my YouTube schedule. So I'm kind of weaving that all into this one video. So there are 5 main responsibilities I focus on each day, and that is creative strategy, social media management, then there is community management, and then business strategy. Let's go through these main 5 responsibilities and I'll break it down a little bit more. So my best creative state is in the morning. I typically wake up at 6:45 a.m. I stretch my body as soon as I get out of bed. I have a pretty ritualistic morning routine and I'm at my computer writing or editing by 7:30. This is where I get in my zone and my creative juices are flowing, so I am able to produce top quality material. So this morning I'm editing my video about the Dominican Republic, which you probably saw, hopefully you saw. It was my upload from last weekend. And what I mean by writing is I'm writing out video concepts. So I finished writing the outline. I've finished kind of scripting what I wanted to say in the intro and the ending. And when I say I'm sitting down to write, I'm writing out video concepts or video outlines or video scripting, or I'm writing for another social media platform. For example, I could be batch creating Instagram posts, which means just writing Instagram copy for like anywhere between, you know, 10 to 14 days in advance. And when I say I'm editing, I'm usually editing my YouTube videos, but that also could mean editing photos, although I find that editing photos is much more mindless and therapeutic. Editing YouTube videos, you really have to be sucked in and you can't really be interrupted because you're creating a story and you really have to zone in on that and focus on that. So all these things I do most days of the week. And the best way and the only way for me to access this kind of state of creativity is to get into a flow state. There's a process to getting into a flow state, and it's about having a ritual no matter what your environment is. All great writers, athletes, artists have a ritual, some kind of ritual for getting into the zone. I always start my morning off at a standing desk, which is one of the things that I need whenever I'm looking for a new place. I need to be at a standing desk or some standing workplace. Standing makes me feel more energetic in the morning. I frequently move positions in my body. It makes stretching easier throughout the day. There's also a ton of research about how it improves attention span and cognitive skills. And for me, it always really helps me to improve my posture to stand. When I'm shooting for a video that day, all of these small habits help me to build up my energy to shoot, because shooting can be super exhausting. And if you schedule a certain time to shoot, you end up always needing to double that time. It just takes so much more time than you think. On these days when I'm either writing, editing, or shooting, I make sure that I have 0 calls and 0 meetings for the day. This is a ritual or a kind of schedule that I've put into place for myself so that I don't have any distractions and I can be hyper-focused. The creative strategy is definitely the most time-consuming and needs the most amount of effort and concentration. And sometimes it takes me days, maybe even a week, to finish one of these individual projects, writing, shooting, or editing. All right, let's move on to how I manage all of my social media accounts. Being present and being super active on my accounts daily is important because I don't want my followers to forget me, and maybe this is even worse, I don't want to look neglectful to my accounts and my followers and the community that I've created. Social media management is also about research, like discovering new trends, checking out what people in my niche or any other niche that I'm interested is doing or posting about. Because every minute of my day is on a strict schedule, I literally cannot afford to spend hours scrolling through social media. So that's how I make every minute count when I'm managing my social media accounts. I would say I spend 20 to 30 minutes max a day managing my social media accounts. First, I spend a few minutes social listening. And what that means is I'm kind of reading up on conversations, on what's going on in social media, on my accounts, on other people's accounts that I follow, people who I find super inspiring, who I go to. So this includes looking up keywords, hashtags, watching reels, looking for brand partners and seeing what their messaging is like, and also checking out the industry news and trends that are going on. Sometimes I'll even take notes while I'm doing this, so I'll jot a lot of things down, whether it's ideas. I'm kind of analyzing what the sentiment is about. So what is the feedback like in these conversations? Are they positive or are they negative? So the last part of the social media management is checking up on my content calendar to see what I've planned to post for the day or for the week. Double checking the visuals, make sure they look all good. Double checking the copy and just proofreading the copy, and making sure the calendar is up to date and it's full at least for the following week. Okay, so social media management is just one piece, and then you have your community management. So before, during, after, in between, all the time, I'm always engaging with my community, responding to comments, going through DMs and responding to those messages, liking other people's posts, sharing other people's posts, and this is all on YouTube, Instagram, sometimes on Facebook, sometimes on TikTok, really never on Twitter. Twitter is very much like a one-way street for me. But this is also where I get to see the feedback from my audience. What they liked, what they didn't like, what they want to see more of, what kind of videos they might want me to make. So this actually helps me to decide what kind of content I'm gonna be planning next. There are several ways I come up with topic ideas and different types of content, which leads us into the business strategy of content creation. I spend a couple hours a month brainstorming video ideas. I keep a running list of all of my video ideas and then plan out my schedule based on the video that I decide that I want to make. And again, I always start with YouTube because that's my main medium. That's the primary social media platform that I focus on. So once I've made the decision on the concept of the video that I want to make, I set a goal for what I want this content to be. And I do that by simply asking myself, what do I want to accomplish with this? What do I want to communicate with this? And what are the things that I want myself and people to take away from this? So for example, when I was staying in Montana, or when I was planning to stay in Montana, I knew I wanted to make a video about working at a cattle ranch. That really put me out of my comfort zone. It's something that I never even thought about doing, and I knew I wanted to do it and I had to do it. So I actually took this idea from my running list, and I had jotted this idea down like months before I even got to Montana. In my attempt to see this video through, I then searched all of the cattle ranches in the Flathead Valley area, which is where I was staying in Montana. I wrote fully detailed proposals and found all of the emails and sent those proposals out, talking about, you know, everything that had to do with like what kind of video I wanted to make. Well, first of all, who I am, what I do, what kind of video I wanted to make, you know, how and why would benefit the business or the brand. So once I heard back from a few of these businesses, I could then talk more openly with them and figure out a really good production plan. So this is basically how I shoot these jobs around the world videos, or lifestyle challenge videos, and it's a playlist under all of my videos. It's called Jobs Around the World. So this is just one example of how I have an idea and then I conceptualize, I plan, propose, and then see it through to its fruition. When it comes to working with brands for paid promotionals or paid advertisements, that's a whole different side of the business. And that also involves conceptualizing an authentic idea, but it's also more negotiating rates and contracts. In terms of my whole production timeline, I try to maintain a production schedule that gives me 2 weeks to work on one YouTube video with all of the content across the rest of my social media platforms to align with that video. So typically on a Monday, I would finish the outline and then probably move on to other tasks and begin filming either Tuesday or Wednesday. But for the sake of this video, I'm kind of condensing the whole process. So I finished writing my outline and then we start filming. So here we are in the production phase of my schedule. Since I'm already in the midst of filming this, I'm gonna go through my shot checklist and figure out what else I need to shoot for this video. Also, one thing that I do while I'm shooting a video is in the midst of it, I make sure to get photos and iPhone videos so I can cross promote this YouTube video across all of my other social media platforms. And this is the repurposing strategy, which should be a huge part of anyone's content creation plan. Because I've chosen YouTube as my main medium, I then leverage that YouTube content in a more powerful way across all of my other social platforms. And the point of this is to help grow my reach and reach wider audiences on all these different platforms. So all in all, this is my content creation strategy. It doesn't happen in one day. It doesn't even happen in one month. It's taken me years to make this kind of solid foundation. And once you do have a solid foundation about your content's topic, type, goal, your medium, frequency, and flow, then all you have to start doing after that is rinse and repeat. And it is getting dark outside, so I'm gonna go ahead and end the day and my work day. And I'm also gonna go ahead and end this video. So let me know what you think. Was this helpful? Do you want me to make more of these content planning and content strategizing videos? Let me know down below. And thank you guys so much for watching. Until next time, take on the world.